Hey guys, and welcome to Simply Radiology. I'm here to show you an easy way to assess radiological images concerning the knee. My wish is to teach you an easy way and to understand that it's not a big science to read radiological images. Anyone can do it. You just have to have somebody to teach you how to do it, and you're gonna be almost all the way there diagnosing most pathologies found here. So with that, I want to first begin with normal anatomy, and then I will show you some nice hints and tips that will take you a really long way in coming to diagnose the x-rays of the knee. So we have the femur here, the proximal bone, the patella is hidden behind here, you can see that nicely. You have the tibia, of course, and the fibula. And don't forget that the fibula is always lateral, so keep that in mind. And because this is lateral, we have the lateral condyles of femur and tibia here, and on this side we have the medial condyles. In the middle you can see the eminentias. Alright, so in every knee x-rays we take four images. One frontal, this one. One side. And two angles of the knee. So one really important way when you're assessing images of an x-ray is first of all not to be too fast, okay? Second of all, make sure you cover the whole image. You will find your way to do that, but make sure every part of the image is assessed by you. In my personal way, what I do is that I follow the cortex here all the way. I follow it clearly and I make sure that there is no irregularities or disruptions. I do the same with every bone that's visible on this film. I just look for irregularities, I look for some strange obvious disruptions. And we do this with every image. So same story here, do not be too fast. Take your time, make sure you check the whole thing out, because that's gonna be your job. Alright, good job. We'll do the same with these ones. Alright, so that was one patient. I want to show you one more normal case, and then we'll move on to some pathologies. Here guys, we have another patient. This one is a bit older female. You can tell quickly that it looks pretty good. The mineral density of the bone is a bit lower in older patients. That's a very common finding. Again, the eminentias are a bit flattened out compared to the last one, indicating some kind of degeneration in the knee joint. Compared to the last one, there is a small bony part here, which is called the os fabella, and it's a very common finding, especially in the knee joint. Please do not mistake this for an avulsion or some bony fragment that's been cut off, please. Because when you assess this part, you can see that it's very round, it has a unified look, and it doesn't look at all like a fracture. Alright, so when you see this, don't be alarmed, it's most likely a normal finding. And just every time, just make sure that the borders are very round and clear. And this way you will make sure it's not a fracture. Okay guys, now we have done the most important part, that is to assess normal anatomy of the knee joint. And don't forget, don't be too fast, follow the whole cortex, look for any irregularities, and find a way to look for the whole picture. And now we'll go over some obvious fractures, and I will show you it's not that difficult to assess these guys. Let's move on. All right, first case, patient with a knee injury to the lower knee. It's very obvious here, guys. There are some strange things happening here. That's a big fracture to the tibia, just below the medial condyle. Remember, lateral, medial condyle. He already has a cast on him, so I guess the clinicians already knew that there was a fracture in this bone without even having an x-ray. Let's always check the at the projections to be safe. And yes, it looks horrible. Okay, good job. Next one. All right, guys, we have the next patient here. Not as obvious as the last one, but let's see what we have. Again, we check the whole thing. Try to look for anything strange. Looks a bit off here. Let's move on. I can't say I see anything amazingly pathological here. But here, boom, there is a fracture, compression fracture of the lateral tibial condyle. You can't see it here, but here it's very obvious. Good job. All right, guys, the next one. And you see this, guys? This is super easy, man. There's nothing difficult about this. And imagine getting paid to diagnose this stuff. Come on, man. Such an easy life. All right, let's check out the angles. So obvious. This thing is dorsally dislocated compared to this part. Okay, let's go to the next one. Here, guys, another big fracture. You can see something strange here, but also up here, look at that. Horrible, man, amazingly bad. You're right, what you see, big fracture, next patient. All right, the next one is here. Not as obvious. I just have one image though. But when you do some contrasting, you can see that there is a strange line happening here. That's not normal, that's a fracture. It's a basically a medial vertical fracture of the tibia. Not very dislocated. On this patient, you can also see calcifications of her femoral artery. So that's atherosclerosis. All right, good job, guys. So as you can see, we have done some really fast imaging of lots of patients in a very short time, and it's not that hard. You just have to find the rhythm, and you'll be so good at assessing these pictures just by practicing. Okay, let's go to something more subtle. All right, guys, we're here back with this one, and this is a really common finding in the knee, and it's can be very subtle, but can sometimes be very obvious. And this is also one important lesson, to always look for stuff outside the bone, so soft tissue. So in this image, you don't see that much. Although here you can see a big pathological finding, and this is collection of blood here, so-called FBI sign. So this part is fat, big blood, and this fat-blood interface is called the FBI sign. And this is a hint of some injury to the knee. Doesn't have to be a bone, but it can be something else, like a ligament rupture or whatever. All right, good job, guys. We have more to do. Next patient is here. Young patient playing basketball, twist his knee, extremely painful. Doesn't look so bad here. What do we have here? Oh, hold on, we have some blood collection here, fat blood interface. And when you follow the whole cortex, you will eventually find this part. There is some strange impression here. And this guy, you can write that it's an impression fracture, fine. But don't forget that this is also a very common finding when it comes to ACL ruptures. So that's good to know. For example, you can write this in your answer to the clinician that they should be suspecting an ACL rupture. So what they did was an MRI, and let's check it out. Here is the MRI picture of the same patient. As you can see, that there is some bone impression fracture here. Not huge, but it's visible. And when you move on to the ligamental part, you can see an intact posterior cruciate ligament. It looks very beautiful. And when you move to the anterior cruciate, you can see that the fibers are completely flaccid, not at all as they should be, indicating a really bad rupture of the ACL. So you have a diagnosis. Good job. Next one. All right, guys, here's one more patient. Let's see what we have. I don't see anything major obvious. Let's check everything out. I don't see anything. We move on. Do you see anything, guys? I do. If you check the bones, there is something strange here. What is that? It's a radiolucent line indicating what? Yes, a fracture. So we have a fracture here, and you can see, guys, it's not visible here. I don't see it, and neither do you. and everything else looks fine. Here is always fibula. Don't mistake this for a fracture. But yes, here is something weird. So, good job. You diagnosed the fracture in the lateral condyle of tibia. All right, guys, here's the next patient. We have an older patient. You can see that the bone density is very, very low. Almost, you can barely see it sometimes. And in this patient, it's a reduced space between the bones, indicating degeneration of the patient and lots of calcifications along her major femoral artery, popliteal artery in the knee. What we have here is a very painful knee, and it's not very easy to see, but there's a line here, and this has to be suspected for a knee fracture. Personally, I don't see anything else on the other pictures, on the other images. So in this patient, they moved on with the CT to assess the extent of the injury, and we'll see what they found. All right, guys, same patient, but CT. We move on. And boom, fracture. Very, very small fracture, barely dislocated. Not anything else majorly on the other bones. Oh, but look here, lateral patella fracture. This wasn't possible to see on the previous x-rays picture, so yeah, this is life sometimes for radiologists. They keep finding stuff they're not wishing to find, but that's life and you have to report on it, so don't be troubled by that. Okay, guys, next one. Okay, here's the next patient, guys. This was a patient sent in polyclinically for assessing the knee joint concerning her arthrosis, and there was a finding that she actually has a fracture here. And you see these radiolucent lines in the bone, in the tibial lateral condyle. This has to be a fracture. And in this patient, it wasn't for some reason very painful, but that's how it is sometimes. All right, guys, so what we have seen so far has been pretty, pretty obvious. So let's move on to something less obvious. All right, guys, the next patient. This guy couldn't extend his knee. So let's see what we have. There are some calcifications up here. Nothing major. Nothing major. Calcifications. What is that? Is that a calcification? No. And when you compare this, this has to probably be a bony fragment that's been ripped off. Because when you look at it, it looks very strange. It doesn't look at all like a bony, round, clear borders. In fact, it's opposite. So in this patient, when you see this kind of image, you know most likely that it's a quadriceps rupture. So quadriceps attaches to the patella, and as the tendon of the quadriceps has been ruptured, it pulled off a piece of the bone. So that's why it's imaged here. Good job, dude. You're gonna be an amazing radiologist. Let's move on. All right, guys, we have our last image today. And I guess you have already found the pathological part of this image. And yes, you're right, it's this here, correct. It's a small fracture of the lateral tibial condyle. And this actually has a name. It's called a second fracture. And it's very important to notify the clinician about this, because it's very indicative of what? Yes, an ACL rupture. So please, when you see this kind of fractures, make sure to warn the clinician of a possible ACL rupture. Most cases, the clinicians really examine the knee well and they are still suspected, so they will still do an MRI to confirm it, but in these cases, you can still mention it just to be nice. All right, guys, so we have done a quick overview of knee x-rays, and this is basically how you work as a radiologist, at least in my home country. My message to give to you is that it's not a big science to interpret images of radiology. In fact, if somebody teaches you quickly how to do it, what to think about, you can do so much yourself. And this is really, if you ask me, this is a really good video for somebody who is outside radiology but just wants to improve his interpretation of x-rays. Because by doing this, you can come really far away, and I'm sure you're gonna see lots of images during your medical career, and this will be a real benefit. Because the more you see, the more you learn, and that is basically my also big message to you, is the concept of learning. I'm sorry to say this, but you have to repeat your knowledge to learn. So if I were you, I would rewatch this video again, just to be sure to not forget everything in 1 month, because it happens. Even though you think you know everything today, trust me, you're gonna forget everything in 1 month. So be smart, put an alarm, watch this thing again in 1 month, and I will be very happy, and you'll be very happy, and we're all gonna be better doctors in the end, or better people too. Alright guys, so I hope you liked this video. I'm trying to make it easy for you guys to assess these images, and if you like this stuff, please subscribe, comment, like, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a good one, guys. Bye.